Oh, I am one tired hombre. I can't wait to... I go through all that work to get the statuette out of Ching's place, and I leave it in the damn speeder. And I didn't even roll up the windows. I am such an idiot! Feels like it's been pounded with a lead pipe. I guess it wasn't a bad dream after all. I wonder how I got here to my office. All I remember is flying pipe and stars. Damn it! After all the trouble I went to get that stupid statuette, someone just walks up and takes it like candy from a baby. And my wallet's gone too. I hope somebody on the street saw me get jumped. I've got 29,000 reasons to get that crystal bird back. Hopefully I haven't used my tube of miracle facial cream. It should help reduce the swelling and make me look almost human again. That's the door to the street. Francesca!
Oh, Tex, why can't all men be like you?
What do you mean, broke, stubbly, and undependable?
Listen, Tex, you are a dream compared to that pig husband of mine. Sal's gone too far this time, and I've got to do something about him. It's humiliating the way he's been flaunting his latest affair with some floozy. If I had some hard proof he's been sleeping around, I could finally divorce him and get some money from him.
You know, Fran, a good PI like myself can come up with hard proof in his sleep.
I bet you can, mister. And that's why I'd like to make a deal with you. I saw you get jumped last night. Sal told me to keep quiet and that telling you would put my life in danger. But I'm willing to talk if you'll give me some proof that Sal is having an affair. Then I could divorce him and get some of the money he's been hiding away all these years.
You drive a hard bargain, Francesca. But I need a lead on my case, so I'll see what I can dig up on Sal.
I don't know anything about the girl Sal is seeing. I've gone through his things, but haven't been able to find anything except for this note. I think it's meant to be a coded message. I'm sorry I don't have anything more for you to work with. Let me know when you've got something.
Louis Laments runs the... Louis Laments runs...
Too bad you don't like fresh brains, mate. Hot off the grill. Franny told me you got whacked. I haven't heard any word on the street about who would have done it. As a matter of fact, he just left. You'd probably be interested to know that he tore up a note and left it in the trash.
Louis tells me he just took the garbage and dumped it in the trash can just outside the Brew and Stew. Some of this devastation came from the Barney the Dinosaur Museum. No one was too upset when it became one of the first structures to get blasted in the war. Everyone refers to this stuff as Barney rubble. This is where Louis throws out the garbage. Street people come from miles around to sample Louis's award-winning leftovers. These must be the note scraps Louis told me about. Thank you. The golden...
This guy comes up to me and says he don't like you hanging around here. So he gives me a bunch of money and says he'll pay me more if I keep you out of here until he goes away.
Boy, word travels fast. Sal must have heard I was working for Franny. I heard Sal visits here a lot, and I'd like to get inside and look around, but Arta won't let me in. Maybe he'd let someone else in, though. The Golden Gate Hotel. Now I've got an Inspector Burns disguise that would fool his own mother. It certainly ought to do the trick on a goofball like Ardo.
It's my hero, Inspector Burns!
Hello, Fire Safety Ranger Ardo. I've come to inspect your fine hotel for fire safety.
Oh boy, this is a dream come true! Ready for inspection, sir!
Well, that's fine, Ardo. Open up those doors for me and I'll inspect your hotel rooms.
All right! I'll open the doors, Inspector Burns.